Hey guys, my name is Steven from GameZ, or should I say Game Switch. I did change the name of the channel now, just to be a little bit more Switch related as far as naming goes. Doesn't mean I am going to concentrate only on the Switch, but my main priority will be Switch and Switch games, but I will have a lot of other interesting videos up as far as, for example, I love phones and anything technology. So hopefully I'll be reviewing some new phones. Maybe new cars. I love everything to do with anything new. So keep up, subscribe, and like my videos. I will be posting many, hopefully at least once a week. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Resident Evil Revelations game that I promised I would do. This is number one. I bought the game, $40, and it brought one of them on the cartridge, and I had to download the other one. The other one I actually downloaded at a really big size. So if we go down to data management, we're gonna see here, manage software. Resident Evil 2 is 23.6 gigabytes, followed by my most regrettable 21 gigabytes on WWE 2K18. I saw it today at Walmart for $40. I am so upset, highly upset. I can't even say it enough. Anyways, I don't even know why Eleanor is actually taking 13 gigs if I have the cartridge. This is crazy. At this rate, my 200 gigabyte card is not gonna last me much. So going back, today I'm gonna do a review of Resident Evil Revelations Part 1. And I am using my Pro controller. Let's see how it looks. Okay, there's a little mini game that they did mention was going to be here while you wait. A lot of games should do this, example WWE with their 10 minute load times, and that's not the Switch's fault. It's actually, how do you kill that? Maybe that's the good guy. So it's my understanding that the game probably has loaded already, but as long as you don't die here, and I died, as long as you don't die there, then you can keep going. When playing with the Joy-Con, make sure to wear, I don't know what it says, strap, I guess. I have this game on the 3DS. I played it for 2 minutes and I put it down. Last Resident Evil I played was probably the fourth one. I earned 20 BP. That's nothing. Probably the fourth one. And that was on, I wanna say this, the GameCube. And if I might be completely wrong, I haven't followed Resident Evil for a while, but okay, it has campaign, raid mode, cooperative mode where you fight enemies of varying difficulty, and the campaign is played in the story mode, of course. Achievements, manual, and options. Under options, we have controls, okay, game settings, okay, and audio, language, Amiibo. Very weird they got Amiibo support in there. Let's play the campaign. And we'll do normal. I can't even see what my buttons look like right now. I'm in the dark to try to get a better picture of this game. Mediterranean Sea. My controller is vibrating. That looks so real. How do they do it, but WWE couldn't do it? It It's just amazing. Pretty amazing. The Switch is so capable, but my question is, if it's more capable than Xbox 360, why is it that other developers are having trouble developing for it? Switch is doomed, looks amazing, but they had to do so much and they made a big deal about it. Xbox 360 games look really good. This looks really good. I don't know if it's just a story mode, so we'll find out.
It's been 94 minutes since Chris and Jessica dropped off the radar.
That's very specific.
The interpolation from their last known coordinates puts them
right here on the ship.
Use a herb taking damage to avoid death. Nice. But actually, look at that. I'm just going to check you out really quick here. Alright. If you could see the particles of water, the lighting, it's amazing. You know what I want on the Switch? Metal Gear games. Any cover system here? No, maybe I can't do a lot right now. That looks great. Where's the water? Beautiful. Nothing holds me here. All right, press A.
The stench.
Yeah, really nice of him to stay right behind me. What a gentleman. Although I would do the same thing. All right, what's this? I just reloaded. There's no ducking here. Interesting. Alright, where are you?
No signs of life, but I feel like something's here.
How about you lead the way, you damn... That looks like... He looks like that actor. I don't know his name right now. Alright. Well, we've got company. Oh, okay. He just disappeared. That does not look like water. Oh god. Just come out here so I can shoot you. Wow. He did go in the vents. He's about to pop out right there, I think. I think I saw the... Holy crap. Well, it doesn't help that I'm in complete darkness right now.
No power, which means no elevator for us.
Alright, so that's a dead end. Lead the way, you damn. Damn.
There's blood coming from the ducks.
I don't think he's alive anymore. And I think somebody's really shy right now. Come out here, little one. Don't be afraid.
It's not working.
I would hope not. There is nothing there. Alright. Okay. What is this? Damn it. Alright. Guy, where are you? You in here somewhere? Somebody needs to clean up here. Oh, well, there's my hero. Just hang in there. I'll be right back. You know, I wish it was just, there was more light here. This is, whoa. Hold on. I really don't want to come in here. Whoa, get me out of here. Seriously, you just stayed out there. I'm trying to find some medicine. There we go. Herbs. Huh. Well, I don't know if we're in Colorado, but I guess I'll take some herbs. Alright, let's see here. Well. Get some candy. I'll get them munchies in a second. Okay, there's still power here. What is that supposed to mean? Okay, so some more things. Okay, I got a handgun ammo, and that one's not opening. Okay, I should just seriously push him into something, get him to help out. Oh god. Yeah. All right. I read that this game, and as I said, I never played any of them, so if you have, leave me some comments and let me know which one you like more, Resident...
Take a look at these.
What? Resident Evil Revelations 1 or 2?
Parker, give me a hand here.
Sure, no problem.
Nice. What the heck is she doing?
I got something.
A gun? Inside the guts?
I think it's a gun.
Now what?
Give me a sec.
She's doing all the work. It's not Chris, but somebody else is mad you just took the gun. Who are you gonna call? Spawn. Damn it. Seriously? Jeez.
This explains our missing crew.
This is not good.
No.
Where are you, Chris?
He's dead. Jeez. I cannot be... I don't care who it is. My wife, my best friend. I will not do that. Find anybody. You can keep them. Saving data, please do not turn off. Switch. Successful. Hitting certain areas on enemies inflicts greater damage. Well, I tried to hit him in the head. It didn't seem to work. News update. What do we got?
This sunny and idyllic Mediterranean coast was the site of one of the world's greatest structures. It took a full 11 years to finish constructing the world's first Aquapolis, the floating city of Terra Grigia. A sustainable metropolis operating on a massive solar energy matrix and equipped with the latest green technologies. Never before had solar energy been used to supply power to an entire city. Now. But in 2004, Veltro, a terrorist group opposing the city's development, launched a bioterrorist attack. They not only released a virus, but also several creatures known as bioorganic weapons, further complicating the situation. This launched one of the worst tragedies the world has ever seen. The FBC, the world's leading counter-bioterror organization operating under the auspices of the U.S., was called in to direct efforts to contain the attack. The BSAA, a counter-bioterror NGO,
nice
which operates independently of the interests of any one country, went in as observers to assist the FBC. Realizing the need for immediate and decisive action, Supreme Local Headquarters issued the order to use the city's solar energy matrix on itself. Media outlets around the world began to refer to the incident as the Terra Grigia Panic. Following the incident, the FBC announced it has successfully disbanded the terrorist group called Veltro.
Veltro, huh?
It is now 2005.
So where are we?
And security is finally returning to the people.
Restricted area, off limits, huh?
As you can see, the lost city of Terra Grigia remains inaccessible. A silent and potent symbol of the threat that bioterror poses for people around the world.
Wow. Nice story. Beautiful graphics. I think I'm back now. Not yet. All right, let's see what we got here.
Ah, there you two are.
O'Brien, you don't normally join the fray.
Well, my doctor told me I need exercise. I assume you both know that the FBC has cordoned off the entire area.
3:50 p.m. Mediterranean Sea Coast.
This big, huh?
Anyone who knows what happened here is going to put two and two together.
And that's why I've sent the BSAA in to investigate. Did you pick up your new equipment from Quint?
Yeah. Genesis, something. Is that its name?
You didn't bother to read the manual, did you?
No, I brought it with me, just in case.
I hope you read quickly. You're gonna need it on your mission.
Yeah, I'm on it.
Well, did he just kill himself? Use physical attacks on enemy when they falter? Okay. Genesis Manual, version 1. Genesis, the nickname of a high-level bioscanner currently being tested and developed by the Global Pharmaceutical Consortium. It balances special... synchrotron, I can't even read that, radiation off of a target in order to analyze it. viral analysis. It is possible to detect and analyze even the smallest amount of viruses. Well, I'm gonna skip that. That's a lot of things that I'm not gonna remember right now. Equip Genesis, L. And scan the trigger. Scan complete. Genesis requires decent sampling.
Get an accurate reading. Scan the carcasses on the beach and send me your data.
Carcasses on the beach.
Something from inside it.
Metal detectors.
Careful now.
Don't worry, I've done this before.
What is that? Hey, you don't think it's a gun anymore. Put that under your pillow.
What is this? If it's an engineered mutation, this could prove a link.
I'll run some tests on this. Continue with the investigation.
Don't give it to him. I feel he's evil. All right. See here. Well, that one's a lot. Let me just scan you while you're alive. There.
For this outfit.
I wanted to be more involved. I wanted to fight.
I see you two are okay. Continue with the investigation, but proceed with extreme caution.
Some more herbs. Alright. So this is... I'm going to leave the video to here. It's very long now. This is a small review of Resident Evil 1 Revelations. I give this game, literally so far from what I've played here, I'm gonna judge it by controls, graphics, a little bit of the story. Again, I am playing on the Pro though, so just remember that. I am going to rate this game about an 8.5 right now. It looks like it's really good, it's involved, you gotta do a lot of investigating, there's a lot you could do here, so I really will give this game a shot. I don't really complete many games, so I am gonna do my best to complete this one and then give it a final score after I have. For now, wow, I'm full of goo. He's got gas. Dum da dum dum dum. Alright, hey there, little one. Alright, so for now I think I can give this game its 8.5 based on controls, graphics, voice. Voice acting is pretty good. And I already did these, actually. Yeah, this acting is good. And, I feel like it's definitely got a lot to offer. I'm trying to see if I can get who, what, you know, what happens at 100 before I end the video. Looks like somebody already raided the place. You know what I wish though? I wish there was a run. Okay, there's a cut. But not a run. Alright, I get myself in the water here. Still no run. Let's see. Alright, come on, let's get to 100 here. It's gotta be in here. It won't open. Something's jamming it. Okay. I don't wanna know what's jamming it. Alright, I need one more. Here we go. That's not it. Should be here. Let's see. These grabbers just look so nice. Alright, I can't go there. I don't even think I can go back up. Something I wish was possible, but doesn't look like it is. I don't know where the last one is. There it is. Alright. Now what?
I've collected enough samples.
Good. Get them to me ASAP.
Show signs of viral infection.
Really?
There is no coincidence they came through the FBC's blockade.
No, that guy reminds me of.
Now, we wait for the results to come back from HQ.
My partner there? Just a little bit like RGT85 guy.
Yeah, it's me.
Really cool.
Sent their last known coordinates to your terminals.
Okay. She got a
signal
Nokia.
Was lost over the ocean.
Yeah, I'm not going out there.
Chasing Veltro. But judging from their position, they must be
on a ship. I'll go back to HQ, take charge of the search
and
rescue.
That looks like Mel Gibson.
You two will be my eyes out there.
Yes, sir.
I'm seeing things. You know what the girl looks like? Oh, what's her name now? I gotta remember all this. I love this little look of this game. I can't even believe it's on a handheld. Alright, accuracy, they give me 100. That's 0. And clear time. Save it. Saving. Alright, so you get to save your data. Pretty good. Alright. And you're all set. So I'm going to hit back. And I can hit next now. Alright, guys. So I'm not going to actually continue. What I am going to do is I'm going to come out of this now. That was my review of Resident Evil Revelations for the Nintendo Switch. I had this game on the 3DS, but just because of how small it is, the controllers are not right on the 3DS. They feel cramped. It doesn't really have an analog stick for real. A very tiny one. I didn't ever get into it. On top of that, the graphics, although they were decent, they weren't great. On the Switch, they are perfect. Everything is perfect about playing this game on the Switch. So my score is unchanged, 8.5 for now. I am going to do another review of Resident Evil Revelations 2 for you guys in the next few days. So this is just a 30-minute, went a little bit over than I thought, 30-minute gameplay and review of Resident Evil Revelations 1 on the Nintendo Switch. Let me know what you think. Comments below. Please subscribe. Like my video. It really helps. And I'll see you all next time on Game Switch.